fans, this is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley's Free Lesson Friday again. Finally, I've been away for a few weeks, maybe a little bit longer than that, basically doing some construction here. You can see things look, well, maybe you can't tell. Let me show you a few pictures to show you what I've been doing. Basically, I rebuilt the smaller stage that I built almost 3 years ago, and I built a permanent stage here, one that's big enough to accommodate a full band so that I can start doing some interesting videos for you guys. In the future. So basically, we're back again, and this week I'm going to talk about something, part of the fretboard that I've not spent a whole lot of time in, going from transitioning between boxes 3 and 4. Not something that I ever had a lot of use for, and if you've learned from me, if you've taken the 5 Essential Blues Boxes course, you know that box 4 has not been my favorite place to play, simply because I didn't know a lot of stuff there. But this is something that I've started doing a little bit more. I think that you'll find it useful. So we're going to tie it all together, mixing major and minor and that kind of thing. If you're new to Texas Blues Alley, this is a part of a collection of videos called Free Lesson Friday, and we've got over 200 of those over at the Texas Blues Alley site. You can find those in a part of the site called the Woodshed. The Woodshed, cleverly named, is the part of the site where we have all of our educational stuff, courses, Free Lesson Friday, that kind of thing. So if you head into the Woodshed under Free Lesson Friday, you can find lessons of all different types and skill levels, all centered around kind of the heart of Texas Blues. I like to say that Texas Blues is the heart, not the border, meaning that it's all centered on Texas Blues, but we cover a lot of different topics. So anyway, let's get into this lesson and take you through kind of what I've been working on here. All right, so let's talk about where we're at. I'm going to be playing in the key of B in standard tuning for this song. That puts a root marker right here at the 7th fret. Box 1 right there. Box 3 in the key of B has the root right here at the 12th fret. As you know, box 3, as I teach it, is the kind of the B.B. King box. What we're going to be talking about is how to get from box 3 into box 4 with a little help from the top of box 1 here in a way that sounds interesting. So basically, let's drop for a second back into box 1 here. In my 5 Essential Blues Boxes course, I talk about how the outline of the box is your typical kind of minor pentatonic blues sound. But inside of box 1 are these kind of hidden notes that kind of switch the sound of box 1 to be a little bit more major sounding. And one of the ways that we can incorporate that is walking up some of those happier sounding notes to the top. So what we're doing there is we're just taking the strings on the G string here, hitting the one in the middle. You'll recognize that as kind of a B.B. King sounding thing. And then hitting that note there, and then up to the top. Now, one of the things that we've done in previous lessons is walk up that way, and then walk down, then walk down the outside. So we're kind of going up the inside of box 1, kind of has a happier sound, and then descending along the kind of outer border. So we're kind of major on the way up, minor on the way down. What we're going to be talking about in this lesson is how to kind of replicate that when you are in box 3 and you want to get some of that same effect without dropping down to box 1. So if we're in box 3 here, and if you want to learn more about how to play in box 3, I have an entire course about B.B. King, some free lessons about B.B. King, and they all pretty much talk about playing in box 3 here. So the little trick here, when we're in box 3, you know what we're usually doing here? Playing those kind of licks. The trick here is to go start here on the root note of the 12th fret, then slide out of box 3 from 12 to 14, then jump up to the E string, 14, 16, and then jumping up here to the root note, which would be the top of box 1, which I can't really get to here, or if we look at box 5, up here on the E string, for just a second and then drop immediately to box four. Okay, get that? We're in box three. All we're doing is taking the same thing that we have done other times down here in box one. And we've transposed that up here. And we're kind of mapping it onto the five essential blues boxes there. Now in practice, there's a couple of places that I want to talk about using this. The first one is over the transition from bar four into bar five, where we go from the one chord to the four chord. And the key to get this to sound right is to transition up to have that note hit as close to possible as the first beat of bar number five as possible. So I got a little 12-bar loop here programmed that I'm going to play over. I'm going to let this first chorus play out so that I can come in fresh at the beginning of the next one. And basically, I'm going to solo in box three over bars one through three and then transition at bar five. You'll hear it. Here we go at the end of a 12-bar chorus. All right, so there, basically, I was just hanging out here in box three for bars one through three. And then I timed it just right so that that note came in right at the top of bar number five where we hit the four chord. So that kind of marked a change in from major. Which sounds nice on that transition to the four chord. Now let's talk about another kind of transition, and that is the opposite. Let's say that we've transitioned to box three in bar four. We're gonna do the reverse. We're gonna transition up from major to minor on the drop from bar four to bar one at, from the four chord to the one chord at bar number seven. So what we saw there was a little reversal of what we did before. We started off with just normal box one soloing and bars one through four. Then when we got to the four chord at bar number five, did a little bit in box three, but transitioned and did this drop into box number four as we dropped to the one chord at bar number seven. Trying to keep track of all these numbers and chords. So anyway, if you're a member of our locals program, there are going to be instant loops around both of those demonstrations. You can practice with them, as well as a backing track in the Pro Player. But anyway, just kind of big picture again, the idea behind this lesson was to give you a way to transition combining box three and four using that little root right there. Mixes major and minor, has a very cool sound. It mimics what we do down here. Just an octafier. Anyway, I find it's a useful thing to have in case you want to get that sound when you're at that point in the fretboard, especially if you're in a higher key like this where you can't really jump up into box one to replicate what we do down here. Anyway, I hope that's useful to you. And again, you can find all our free lessons over at Texas Blues Alley in the Woodshed under Free Lesson Friday. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.